Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. In this video you will learn what are lipids. But before that, we make sure to subscribe to our channel and turn the notification on. Lipids are organic compounds that are made up of long polymers, like carbohydrates. Their basic components are including carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, and nitrogen. Lipids have diverse structures, but the most common functional groups they contain is carbonyl and alcohol groups. Lauric acid is an example of a simple lipid, which contains 12 carbon atoms with 2 oxygen atoms and 24 hydrogen atoms. As it shows, they contain carboxyl functional group bonded at the end of the main chain. Lipids in general contains really low amount of hydrophilic components. Hydrophilic components have high affinity to water. However, they mostly contain hydrophobic components. That's why they are mostly insoluble in water. They have low melting points. Common lipids are including triglycerides, which are from animal fats and plant oils, glycerophospholipids, which are detergents, sphingolipids, which are nerve cell membranes, steroids and fat-soluble vitamins. Fats, oils, waxes, and sterols are collectively known as lipids. Lipids contain one or more fatty acids with carboxylic acids, with long polymers of carbon, which are being divided into two categories: saturated and unsaturated. Unsaturated fatty acids include monounsaturated, which means they contain one double bond, and polyunsaturated fatty acids, which means they have multiple double bonds. In animal fats, there are two essential molecules, which are linoleic acid and linolenic acid. These essential fatty acids are polyunsaturated, which are mostly derived from plants. The melting points of lipids containing fatty acids increase as the length of the carbon chain increases, and decrease as the level of unsaturation, which means the double bonding increases. Note that the melting points of unsaturated fatty acids are also affected by geometric isomerism. There are two conformations for unsaturated fatty acids, which are including cis conformations and trans conformations. Cis conformation have lower melting points than trans conformations because they cannot pack closely together, which would increase intermolecular force. Triglycerides. Triglycerides are being used for different purposes. It is mostly being used by the animals and plants. Triglycerides helps to prevent water loss, store of fats, and provide a barrier against microorganisms, provide thermal insulation. Triglycerides are lipids that contain 3 fatty acids and glycerol, which is propane 1,2,3-triol, which make up of very large esters. Triglycerides are a type of fat found in the blood. They are the most common type of fat in the body. Triglycerides are necessary for health, but in excess amounts, causing blockage of arteries and increase the risk of heart disease. In general, fatty acids are made up of 10 to around 30 carbon atoms long, which are mostly unsaturated. However, they can be saturated as well. Triglycerides undergo saponification reaction, is a type of organic reaction between an acidic ester and a strong base to produce fatty acid salt. This reaction has the same function of hydrolysis. In this reaction, triglycerides involves boiling the animal fat or plant oil with excess aqueous sodium hydroxide, in which it breaks the 3 ester linkages in the triglyceride molecule. As the result, it produces a glycerol molecule and 3 fatty acid salts. The salt in this reaction is called sodium palmitate, which in real life is often called soap. This soap is amphipathic, which it means having both hydrophobic and hydrophilic parts. This soap contains a small hydrophilic tail-like end, which is made of the carbon chain. This is important for the cleaning action of the soap. Dirt and grease are hydrophobic, so they are attracted to the hydrophobic part of a soap. When the cleansing takes place, the water dissolves the hydrophilic part of the soap, because the hydrophilic part can generate polar interactions. However, the hydrophobic part of the soap remains with the grease and dirt. Over the time, the remaining soap breaks the grease or any dirt into very smaller and smaller particles that was attached to the hydrophobic tails of the soap molecules. Each dirt particle can then dissolve in water, because the surface of each dirt particle contains only the hydrophilic heads of the soap molecules. Note that in clean water this process occurs, but in the hard water this process does not occur. Hard water contains high concentrations of calcium, magnesium, iron 2+, and iron 3+. when soap is used in hard water. The metal cation in the water neutralizes the hydrophilic component of the soap, which participates, and insoluble compounds are formed. Therefore, more soap needs it. So that some of the soap molecules still have sodium or potassium and can perform the cleaning action. I hope you enjoyed this lesson. Thank you for watching my video.